The layer menu allows you to apply various settings and modifications to the layers in your document. Use the layer command to create a new layer. Duplicate a layer. Delete your layer. Adjust layer properties. Apply layer styling. Hide layers. Arrange layers stacking order. Align layers. Lock them. Link them together. Merge your layers. And finally, flatten your image. You can also create a new layer through your selection. Layer, new. You can either create a new layer via copy or via cut. There is a fun feature in Layers menu. Layer style command. It allows you to create different effects for your layer, like drop shadow, inner glow, contour your layer. We will be covering these features in more details. However, just like anything else, I encourage you to play with this feature and explore it on your own. While layer menu is very useful, most of the features and commands could be found in the layer palette. If you click on the option arrow on the top right corner, or right-click on the layer, use icons at the bottom of the palette, as well as some tools. Use selection tool, right-click, and I can layer via copy or layer via cut. And Move tool gives me access to aligning layers in the option bar. And finally, layer styling can be accessed by simply double-clicking on the layer. The Select menu controls how images and areas of images are selected. Use the Select menu to select all of an image. To deselect the selection, inverse your selection, select areas by color range, and apply transformation to selected boundaries. Next to the Select is the Filter menu. It is used to change the appearance of images by applying various effects. The Filter menu contains categories such as Artistic, Blur, Brushstroke, Distort, and more. All of that could be accessed through Filter Gallery. This feature is hardly used in fashion industry, but it allows you to be creative and maybe add a wow factor to your presentation. We encourage you to play with it on your own. The View menu allows you to manage how the document is viewed. Use it to zoom in or out of your document, or my favorite Fit on Screen that allows me to maximize my workspace. Preview actual image pixels or print size. Set different modes. I prefer standard screen mode. And display extras, like grid. You can access grid preferences, like subdivisions and color, through the preference menu. I prefer 8 subdivisions, which will equal 1/8 of an inch, and change color to slightly darker. You can also hide or display your rulers. And finally, manage your guides by locking them, creating new, or deleting. In the window menu, you can arrange how document windows are displayed. You can cascade them, tile them horizontally or vertically. As you could see, all my open documents now nicely arranged in my workspace. In addition, you can create a new window for an active document. This feature is very useful when you work on the image in the zoom mode. But still want to see how the changes that you've made affect the entire document. Workspace submenu can be very useful. Everything that you've seen on the screen, aside from your documents, is the part of the workspace, like tools, menu bar, and palettes. Right now, we're working in the default Photoshop workspace, which can be customized to meet your own needs and save for the future use. Your custom workspace presets will be listed at the bottom of the menu. I will be talking more about workspace when we will get to palettes. The next important segment in the Windows menu is the list of palettes that can be added to or removed from your workspace. Whenever you need to work with a specific palette and it's not displayed on your screen, you can find and activate it in your Windows menu. At the bottom of your window menu, you will find the list of currently open documents with the active document checked. You can change it by clicking and selecting another document to activate. Just like any other software, the Help menu has all the information about the program, tools, and features. That concludes our section about the top menu bar. And in the next segment, we will explore the tool palette.